Folks, Kerry Wood is blowing smoke tonight. Three straight strikeouts, one out in the second, and Bagwell, all he can do is shake his head and hope Kerry gets a little tired. Yeah. One out.
When you see Kerry Wood throwing like this, and he is bringing some heat, guys like Jeff Zahn, Jose Vizcaino, Richard Hidalgo, Lane, and Alan Zinter, they're like, I'm glad I'm not in there right now, because he is blowing some high, hard heat.
Man, here's Darrell Ward hitting 271. Gotta respect this kid's power. He's the only man, or the first man, to hit a ball into the Allegheny River at PNC Park in Pittsburgh. That's a blast of about 500 feet.
Well, if he hits one now, I'm gonna be impressed. Into the Allegheny.
Can't hit what you can't see right now. Carey is free and easy. And when he gets that over with that fastball, it's a long afternoon or evening. Nothing in two to Ward. Hate to say it, but folks, if you're watching at home, this might be a good time to think about setting your VCR. This is reminiscent of so many Kerry Wood starts where that strikeout pitch just continues to be there for him. Ward in a real deep hole, nothing in two the count. And that one blooped down the left field line. Long run for everybody. Can Alou get there? Diving try. He can't. Darrell Ward dumps a double perhaps into left field. And he's on with one man out here in the second inning. Comes outfield playing deep with the wind blowing out. Right. No chance for anybody to catch up.
And that's the one thing you have to do and take into consideration. Gary Darrell Ward, the 27th double of the year. And because the wind is blowing straight out, Alou had to play very deep. You can't defense the balls in front of you, but you can defense the balls behind you. Try to keep it, those extra base hits to a minimum. Therefore, those little bloop hits you can't do anything about.
But you've got to worry about this man, Orlando Merced. He's a good fastball hitter, and he wears the Cubs pitching staff out.
Yeah, hit his 100th career home run yesterday, so he's past the century mark.
Ground ball right side. McGriff handles the big hop, bobbles the ball, and that nearly cost Kerry Wood. But Kerry got to the bag in time to retire Merced for out number two. That was nearly disastrous.
The good thing is Fred McGriff had plenty of time to get Orlando Merced. And you see guys going up there swinging at the first pitch, and why not? Say Kerry Wood can't strike us out if we hit the first pitch, and McGriff, a little bobble here, bobble there, but fortunately for him, it was early. As he tried to make the transfer. Don't matter how you do it, just as long as you get the out.
I'm kind of upset he didn't go behind the back like Michael Jordan would have.
Yeah.
Here's Jeff Blum, runner at third, two outs. Blum hitting safely in 10 of the last 15 he has played. It's been a nice surprise for the Astros. They traded Chris Trubi to get Blum from Montreal. Blum, a switch batting third baseman. He started the season slowly with the bat, but obviously has come to life. I think he's going to grow into a real nice offensive player.
Sure, what happens a lot of times, you feast your eyes on the small ballpark in Houston, in Minute Maid Park, and a lot of times you go up there and you're not a home run hitter, but you find yourself wanting to hit more home runs. And Jeff Blum, what have you done? You take that theory out of your mind and say, let me go up there and hit line drives, and once you get the home runs out of your mind, you'll be okay.
But Wood falls behind him with Ausmus waiting next. Three balls, no strikes. Carey trying to turn in the fourth consecutive great start. From this Cubs staff, the rookies Pryor, Zambrano, and Steve Smyth in Coors Field sported a 2.36 earned run average. And there's a little looper into left field. That's going to score the game's first run. Two bloops by Houston. All you need is contact. Wood's going to supply the power. Ward scores. Blum drives in his 44th, and Houston has an early 1-0 lead.
The thing when you're facing a power pitcher like Kerry Wood, with two strikes, you want to cut your swing down. Jeff Blum does that here. Doesn't take that big hack, and that was a very good pitch by Kerry Wood. That ball was down and in, and Blum did a good job of hitting. Looping it out into left field. And Chip, you talk about the starting rotation, the youngsters. I mean, this is good for this rotation to have the competition they're having now. And you know, Kerry Wood.
Miller in between hop, good play, and that'll retire the side. One run, two hits. Blum with a two-out soft single to left, drives home Darryl Ward, and Fred McGriff will try to tie the game next.
This portion of Chicago Cubs baseball on WGN is brought to you by the 4,000 CarQuest auto parts stores across North America. You'll find it at CarQuest.
Joel Larson's about to go where no man has gone before.
You don't want to be late for school.
Back in time.
I'm 34 years old.
Now he's trapped in the past, and he's years ahead of his time.
Someday there's going to be a thing called bungee jumping. Don't do it.
Do-over. Coming this fall to WGN.
Find the seams. It's the splitter. No, it's the high heat.
Did I lock my keys in the car? Is that so, sir? Going for my Pepsi. Sammy.
The 1 liter big slam from Pepsi. More of the taste you go for.
It's just the same old thing. I need adventure, excitement. I'm suffocating.
Okay, you can drive.
Spice things up. The Hyundai Santa Fe. V6 power, full-time four-wheel drive, and the freedom of America's best warranty plan. The Santa Fe.
Don't even think about it.
This portion of Chicago Cubs baseball on WGN is brought to you by the Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Hyundai dealers. If a Cubs player hits a homer today, write down the distance and the player's name and send it to WGN-TV. You can win 2 round-trip tickets to any Southwest Airlines destination.
As of today, no action has been taken to set a strike date, and the next item will be a conference call on Friday.
I tend to be an optimist, and I don't want to tell people that, you know, by doing this, there's a guarantee that there won't be a strike, but obviously by doing this, we have seen progress, and that's a good thing.
And that is what we were alluding to today. The Major League Baseball Players Association, its executive council, met at an airport hotel out near O'Hare today. There was talk that maybe a strike date would have been set today as McGriff gets hit by a pitch to open up the inning. That action obviously did not take place after a 3.5-hour meeting. Talks are going to continue Tuesday in New York between players and baseball's management. And the good news is no strike date has been set. Players feel that progress is being made. However, you have to keep in mind, Don Fehr intimated that there would be a conference call again Friday, and if more substantive progress was not made, the possibility of a date being set then was not ruled out. But at least for now, both sides seem optimistic. Both sides seem to be moving toward a resolution of some very big issues. They have not yet gotten together yet on the luxury tax and how to share revenues more fully in baseball. But some of the other issues apparently are starting to be resolved, Joe, and that's good news, obviously.
And Chip, I would like to think that this will get resolved, because it's a positive step in the right direction that the players have not yet started to set a strike date. They know the best time for them is during the season when they have the most leverage, but that is the last thing that they want to do, because their ultimate goal is to get a settlement.
And obviously both sides, you're right on target, both sides know there's enormous pressure. The public backlash over yet another potential work stoppage for either side is going to be catastrophic, and no one wants to be blamed again for not coming together in a business where there are $3.5 billion of revenue. Surely everybody can find a way to come away financially very, very happy. And also, you've got the September 11th factor. Nobody wants to see baseball be again a divisive part of our society when our country has done such a great job of uniting in the horrific tragedies of nearly a year ago. And don't underestimate that sentiment on either side of the bargaining table.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. You cannot overlook that, and that's going to play a huge role, and just puts things in perspective. And baseball is, you look at that, baseball is not really that important.
Two balls and a strike to Alou, and that's outside. But again, keep in mind, while they are talking, still no final agreement on drug testing, still no final agreement on luxury tax, still no final number on revenue sharing. Those are three hugely important core issues that have to be resolved as Alou's on with ball four, two men on, and nobody out. And Oswalt threatening to give the lead given to him by his offense right back here in inning number two. But again, congratulations to the players. I think they did a very wise thing. Now it's up to owners and players to get this thing settled once and for all. And an unsolicited opinion, I hope.
Yeah, that would show the fans an incredible amount of loyalty, and it's something that they need to really, the fans need to receive back.
So as the talks continue tomorrow and beyond, we'll let you know what progress is made, and hopefully everyone will walk away from the table happy, and finally a complete and true partnership will exist in this game, something that has been missing for a long time. Here's Corey Patterson, and he lines that ball down the left field line and out of play for a strike two count. Lost in all the home run hitting of Sammy Sosa was the fact that Mr. Patterson had himself a pretty good day in Colorado.
Yes, indeed. Two home runs, and he's breaking out of that slump that he was in for such a long time. But three RBIs yesterday, and he had one to straightaway center field. And then on an 0-2 pitch inside, he just threw the hands and hit it a ton in Colorado.
And Corey swings and misses at a good live Roy Oswalt fastball for out number one. Want to send along greetings to my kids watching the game tonight down in Orlando, Florida.
You got kids?
Stefan and Christopher Carey are allowing their Bob the Builder videotapes to be interrupted for a Cubs game. And my daughter Summerlin, being a good big sister as well, they're all getting ready to come on the big airplane to Chicago and see the Cubs play this weekend. Of course, to my beautiful wife Susan, whom I love very much, can't wait to see as well. Hope everybody's doing well at home. High pop up on the infield. Blum's going to make that play at third base. And after two on, nobody out, both Patterson and Gonzalez failed to deliver. That was an infield fly, and Alex automatically out. And here's where it gets dicey. Todd Hundley's going to get booed unmercifully.
Times you don't want to upset the hometown fans.
Todd made some comments,
yes,
while in Colorado that probably were not the smartest things he's ever said, basically saying, look, I don't want to hear it from the fans until they've hit a 95 mile an hour fastball.
And a lot of them are not going to hit a 95 mile an hour fastball.
And without being callous, he hasn't hit many of them either. So I think they have every right to express their displeasure. One ball, no strikes from Oswalt. Hundley, the number eight hitter, with Kerry Wood waiting on deck. Obviously, Todd frustrated. He was very honest in his self-criticism. He said, if I fell out of Lake Michigan, I probably wouldn't hit water. He's frustrated. And I think he has to understand there's only one way to get people off his back, and that's to produce and to play better. And there's only one man that can control that.
And that is Todd himself. And, you know, speaking with him earlier today, we talked about a lot of things up there, and I talked to him a little bit about hitting, but he said no one ever told him the things I was talking about. And I said the one thing he has to do, he has to think about hitting the ball to left field. Right now he's too pull conscious, and because he's so pull conscious, he wants to make up for the year and a half he has not had all in one swing, and you can't do that. You can't live in the past.
2-0. Oh, missed outside. Three balls, no strikes. Even a slumping Todd Hundley, the Astros figure, is more dangerous than the pitcher Kerry Wood, who's waiting on deck. So you can 1% of the time, which is true, though. One ball, two strikes. Hot, muggy night in Chicago. Weather approaching tonight, and much cooler temperatures expected for the rest of this homestand. That'll be welcome relief. It's been smoking hot up here.
Oh no, you want to keep it hot, man. Nice and warm. Think about all those days in April and May when they were talking about how cold it was here in Chicago.
How about a happy medium? We don't seem to ever have that happen too often.
Just never complain about it being warm. I love it when it's hot.
And Oswalt goes fishing. Hey, he's got a right-handed Fred McGriff swing, doesn't he? That little helicopter. And four strikeouts for Kerry Wood on the night. Don't want to give these guys too much more, for Oswalt doesn't give up many himself.
No, and that's what you have to be careful of. And with the wind blowing out, do you think the hitters may have the advantage? No. Good pitching will always stop good hitting. And right now, Kerry Wood and Roy Oswalt are good pitchers.
And they might be getting another good one back pretty soon. The Astros have sorely missed Carlos Hernandez in their rotation. Ouch. Lugo got smoked on the left wrist. One that got away from Wood. McGriff got hit, you recall, and Houston cannot lose Lugo, and he got smoked.
Ow. That did not sound very good. Taking the cold spray out, ethyl chloride.
What hurts worse, the baseball or the spray?
Well, that spray right now, it burns because you try to freeze the area where it happened, and now Carlson, home plate umpire, is having a talk. Mark Carlson, a little talk,
and he is going to warn everybody. Now this is part again. This is where the umpires are really put in a tough spot. You know that McGriff got hit. Now Lugo gets hit. Kerry Wood and Oswalt both like to pitch inside, but baseball is starting to adopt a zero tolerance policy with regards to guys getting hit by a thrown baseball. And when you ask the umpires to determine a pitcher's intent, you're asking for a whole lot of problems, and you're asking for an impossibility, because now you're taking away one of the strengths of Wood and one of the great strengths of Oswalt, because if a pitch gets away, if you warn them, you got to throw them out.
Right. You're absolutely right. And as a hitter, you use that to your advantage, because now when the ball comes inside and you take a look at being hit by the pitch, the pitcher, Wood, has 15 now, so he leads the league in hitting hitters. But I don't think that was any kind of retaliation. Oswalt really wasn't throwing at McGriff. I don't think that Wood was throwing at Lugo. I mean,
well, especially with the stat you just saw, if Wood had two guys hit on the ear, you'd say, well, okay, maybe. He's hit 14 guys already.
He's a power pitcher with a good curveball, an occasional curveball that will get away. A fastball gets up and in, and when he's throwing the ball 98, 99 miles an hour, I mean, the ball is going to run somehow, some way. I mean, right there, that's why I say hitters always have the advantage right now, because the umpires are really on the hitter's side, and if you can take away that inside corner, you're going to extend your arms.
Let me ask you this. Look who's coming up next. Craig Biggio has been hit more than any other active player. Don't you think if he thinks a pitch is close, he's going to stand in?
And right there, I mean, Lugo just comes around, squares around the bunt.
I mean, don't you think Biggio, if he's smart, he's going to stand in and try to get hit and maybe get Wood out of this ball game?
He would love to get him out.
And now a long extended conversation with Jimmy Williams, and I don't think Lugo's going to be able to continue.
Jose Vizcaino is going to come back in, but that ball sailed away. And a lot of times, you know, when you see a guy square around like that, I mean, the natural inclination is that you're going to throw the ball up and in, and that's what a lot of pitchers are always taught. When you see a guy square around like that, you throw it up and in because he's thinking about bunting, make him have second thoughts. Nolan Ryan was always good at that, Chip.
So you can understand baseball's perspective in that they are trying to protect the hitters. But in doing so,
take away the strength of a pitcher,
and you're trying to make the umpires Nostradamus, and that's just not going to be the case.
Yeah, because if they had a zero tolerance, you talk about when Sean Esses hit Roger Clemens, everybody knew it was coming. Why didn't they throw him out then?
So Vizcaino, just rewarded with a contract extension, is on at first base. He'll stay in the game for Houston at shortstop. And as soon as we get an update on Lugo, we'll pass it along to you. I've got to figure, as hard as he was hit, he's going to head off for some x-rays. That pitch inside, and Biggio backs away. One ball, no strikes. I mean, you as players know when a guy's coming after you with that thrown ball and not, don't you?
No, you have an idea exactly if someone's really throwing at you. In that particular time, I mean, when he squared around, I mean, a lot of times a pitcher will come up and in like that because he doesn't want him squirting around. And that's really going to take away the effectiveness of Kerry Wood, albeit his first pitch to Biggio was inside. He says, hey, I may have gotten warm, but I'm going to stick with my gun and what got me here.
And The problem is, if he does hit him or someone else intentionally or not, Mark Carlson's going to get screamed at by every member of that Houston dugout saying he's got to go out of the game.
Well, it doesn't necessarily mean that because someone gets hit that they'll have to be thrown out. If he feels it's going to be intentional, in no way would he think that after the first guy got hit, if Biggio was to get hit, I don't think he would possibly think that it would be on purpose.
Well, let's see if Carey can regain his composure. As big and strong and tough as he is, he's still a pretty compassionate guy. You never want to see a man knocked from the game with a pitched baseball. Carey's got to put that out of his mind now, because down a run with Biggio, Berkman, and Bagwell, if you let your concentration wane, they'll make you pay. Ground ball to third, ought to be two, five, four, three. Inning over, no runs, no hits, none left. Lugo knocked from the game by a hit batsman. And Kerry Wood leads off the third, trailing by a run.
Log on now for Southwest Airlines $39 to $99 internet specials. Purchased by August 19th.
You are now free to move about the country.
We'll do something. We'll do something soon.
We can turn you on to loads of TV channels.
Incredible.
We can turn you on to lightning fast internet connections.
This would be so fun.
We can turn you on to local and long distance phone service with all the features you're looking for. But we know there are times when you want to escape the everyday.
Hi. Too busy relaxing right now. Leave a message.
And we can help you do that, too. AT&T Broadband. Cable television, high-speed cable internet, digital phone service. The power of three.
They're back. Popeye's Firecracker Shrimp. Tender, crunchy shrimp packed with Popeye's explosive flavor. Just $3.99 with fries, dipping sauce, and a biscuit.
Hey, it's me, Peter. But you knew that. Look, I don't know how to say this, but... You know, I need to move on. I mean, you probably noticed that I'm not the same person I was a few months ago. I mean, you have been great, really. I just need to be on my own for a while. Well, thanks for everything, and guess this is goodbye, huh?
The extremely therapeutic Acura TL Type S.
This portion of Chicago Cubs baseball on WGN is brought to you by Acura. Experience the performance today at your local Acura dealer.
Kerry Wood will lead off the third inning against Roy Oswalt. Kerry hitting 125, Joe.
All right. Well, that's a buck and a quarter.
See what I mean? No homers and a couple of RBIs.
I can say a buck and a quarter,
yeah,
but
yeah,
a buck nine?
That's what it is. I mean, you know, you don't say a buck 09.
No, you say 109. I mean, a buck and a quarter sounds a little bit better.
Well, it is. It's
nice, it's even six, number.
It's 16 better. One ball, two strikes to Kerry Wood. Bellhorn and Miller to follow here in the third inning. Very well pitched game. Cubs looking for their first base hit. Had a chance to score last time, up first and second with nobody out, and did not hit the ball out of the infield. One away for Bellhorn. And tonight the Cubs are proud to recognize a man who gave Major League Baseball four decades of great service as a baseball scout. John Hennessy began his scouting career in 1961 with the Cubs. After a three-year stint with the Milwaukee Braves, he rejoined the Cubs for 36 more seasons before ending his career in 2002. Tonight, Cubs general manager Jim Hendry presented him a plaque in recognition of a job well done. And boy, you got to salute Jim Hendry, the Cubs, and John Hennessy. Scouts are the lifeblood of Major League Baseball, and they toil in such great anonymity. There ought to be, in my opinion, a scouts wing in the Baseball Hall of Fame. For without these guys, bird dogging the high schools in the back roads of this country, yes, guys like Roy Oswalt from Kosciusko, Mississippi, aren't discovered.
Who? Where?
So,
Kosciusko.
Exactly. John Hennessy, who signed Cub catcher Joe Girardi, among the many players he's helped enter the professional ranks, is honored tonight. So our thanks to John Hennessy.
Now the scouts, they are the important clogs.
Line over Vizcaino's glove. He just checked in at short, And there's your first Cub hit.
Yeah, every team needs a great scout farm system, because they can find guys like Mark Bellhorn here. And Mark Bellhorn has just turned it on since he has been put into the leadoff position. 18 home runs. Now he gets the first hit for the Cubs. See if they can get a little action going, maybe a little hit and run here, because Roy Oswalt doesn't look like he's going to give up too much, and neither is Kerry Wood this evening.
Bill Miller grounded out to short, his first and only time up. Remember, Joe, even Tato had a great scout. 1-0, Houston the lead. We're in the third. Just making sure you're paying attention over there.
Okay, Jay.
Off-speed pitch. Boy, for a kid that throws so hard, that's a real nice weapon, isn't it? He reminds me a lot of Juan Cruz. Doesn't he?
He does, because he comes right at you. And what I like about Oswalt is he has good action on that changeup. I mean, he gives you great arm speed, and that's what a lot of guys would tip their changeup off. They'll tip it off by slowing down their motion, and you can see it. But with Oswalt, he speeds everything up as if a fastball is coming, and that's the sign of a very mature and confident pitcher.
Well, as you mentioned, 25-8, 44 major league starts. I mean, that's
not too shabby.
Unbelievable. Ground ball toward third. That might be two again. Second base one. Look at Biggio dance around the bag. Nifty double play turned around the horn by Houston. The Cubs settle for one hit, and that's it. After three, Houston still leads it 1-0.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Let's play The Stranger.
Okay.
When someone gets home tonight, someone should be wearing a naughty French maid's outfit, a blonde wig, and holding a six-pack of Bud Light.
Me likey The Stranger. Oh,
for the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down.
Wow, hello, stranger.
Make it a Bud Light.
Opportunities are everywhere. If you know where to look, like at the Lexus Golden Opportunity, where you'll find special values on all your favorite vehicles. Don't let this one slip through your fingers. See your Chicago area Lexus dealer.
I think do-it-yourself is very much an attitude. It's just such an American tradition. The sense of satisfaction at the end of having done it at home, done it ourselves, that's something that's wonderful and it's very American. The biggest challenge for any do-it-yourselfer is having the right tools.
1800 Craftsman hand tools, all made in America, guaranteed forever.
I always think that good tools are the key to a job well done.
Hey Cubs fans, with summer road construction, public transportation is a quick, convenient way to get you to the game. Take the train or bus, and the CTA takes you right to the gates of Wrigley Field. And remember, if you do drive, come early, enjoy batting practice, and take advantage of the early bird discount.
I have $100 in my bank account, and 75 of that is for a Belgian wax tomorrow.
What's a Belgian wax?
Just a plain old wax, but it hurts so much I treat myself to a waffle afterwards.
Will and Grace, 5 days a week, coming this fall to WGN.
Joe, we got to get some new chairs on with this booth, man.
Why is that?
These Naugahyde chairs make you sweat.
Oh,
it's very uncomfortable.
Nothing a couple of towels wouldn't be able to handle.
Well, Springer, unbelievably talented. AD Eric Welch, head down and take care of that for us. We'd be a lot more comfortable up here.
With the new chairs?
That one.
All right, that'd be good.
I was told they were on order, but I don't make those decisions. No balls, two strikes.
Well, you know what? But, I mean, a lot of people out there are probably watching the game and listening to us on the TV, so.
Well, we sound comfortable, but we're really.
And the emailers, they might be able to find out or tell us what's the best, the most comfortable chair. And you can email Chip and I at CubsTV@ChicagoSports.com. The email's up and running, so.
I mean, any chair. Any chair that we don't have to pay for is okay, I mean, but.
Yeah, that. That's something you're very good at, not paying for it.
Boy, that is the pot calling. Two balls, two strikes.
Yeah, back in the old days, they used to always stand and do the games.
What do you think I'm doing now?
Yeah, there you go. You gotta get that air conditioner first, huh?
Please. Two balls, two strikes. And that's downstairs. Don't want to sound like we're complaining. We're all doing this in good nature fun, but
speak for yourself.
This booth is like a thermos. It's hot when it's hot, cold when it's cold.
And the chef Robert has brought you a towel, Chip, so
thank you, Robert. I appreciate that.
It's not gonna help. Chip, you need a bigger towel.
Oh, now see. That's just wrong. 3-2 pitch. He went around. Wood has a strikeout. That's five of them, and he's only in the fourth inning. Okay, Sneed. Berkman punches out twice.
Well, it's tough. There's that, oh man, there's that wicked slider. And 3-2. Man, it is tough to lay off that pitch because it's coming in on a left-handed hitter, and most left-handed hitters like the ball down and in, but not that wicked.
You're in a feisty mood tonight, I can tell. Bagwell struck out on a 99-mile-an-hour fastball last time up. Cardinals trail the Pirates 3-0 after three. Jason Simontacci having some problems again. Ramirez, Mikoviak, and Young, RBIs for the battling Buccos, have been one of the division's most surprising teams. There is a drive, and all Alou can do is admire that one. Way out on the street to Waveland. A long solo home run for Bagwell, number 21, and Houston has a two-run lead.
Well, sometimes you can go to the well once too often, and when you get burned, you can get burned by Jeff Bagwell, and get burned he did. 21st home run this season, 370th of his illustrious career, and right here, he just came with the heat, and Carey knew it, so did Jeff. And that's why I say, no matter what, and take a look at Alou. He's just like, I wonder how far that's going to land.
So the Cubs have an uphill climb tonight against Oswalt. They trail by two, and Bagwell with that massive uppercut swing. And how about the throw from one of the ball hawks?
I guarantee
nearly
you.
Hit Alex Gonzalez at shortstop.
That guy's got a pretty good arm, whoever threw that.
Well, both these teams have bullpens that could use a little help right now. Sign him up. Give him a tryout. 21 homers for Bagwell, his second career against Wood. And here's Darrell Ward, who doubled and scored his first time up. Big Cub fan Greg Costa watching us tonight on the WGN Superstation. Greg, one of the fine television sports producers in the industry. Big star out in Los Angeles these days, probably dating a Hollywood actress or two.
They don't do that in Hollywood, do they?
Huh?
They don't do that in Hollywood. Stick with one person the whole time, right?
You don't know Greg like I do. Two balls and a strike.
Right now, Jerry Wood find himself in a 2-0 hole. That hole could look even bigger. You have the likes of Roy Oswalt on the mound.
Well, this is a good pitching matchup. We figured it would be. Houston has scored first here tonight. They're playing great ball. They've won 27 of their last 40 games. Remember, at one point, they were 10 games under 500. They enter play tonight 4-over. There's another high fly ball belted right center field. That's real trouble. Patterson back as far as he can go, and it's back-to-back homers for Bagwell and Ward. You elevate the ball, these guys are going to catch up to the fastball. And Ward got a fat 3-1 pitch, and he's got 9 homers, and Houston off to the races leading by 3.
Well, the good thing is there have been all solo home runs. Bad thing is it's a 3-0 lead. Carey Wood gives up back-to-back home runs, and watch where this fastball is. Early in the first couple of innings, Chip, he was getting that fastball more up in the zone, and you can pitch up in the zone when you got a 98, 99 mile per hour fastball. But when you keep that ball down around belt high, you're going to get tag like that because Kerry Wood fastball was straight. If he gets it up around the letters, then he's going to be successful. And that's where he was the first two hitters, first two innings.
Six times this year now, Houston has had back-to-back home runs hit. Surprisingly low total considering the Crawford boxes that greet them in their home park. And that one ticketed up the middle. Gonzalez, 360 spin, what a play! Whoa, what a great grab by Gonzalez. Kerry Wood skipped the rope up the middle. And Alex, with a great pirouette, beat Merced by a step to first.
A web jam, if I ever saw one right here, a breaking ball under the glove of Kerry Wood, and Alex Gonzalez on the second base side, 360 spin. Tremendous play from a guy with great range.
So here's Blum. Blum drove in the first Houston run. Before hitting Julio Lugo, interesting note, Kerry Wood threw 39 pitches, 25 of them strikes. Since then, he's thrown 10 strikes, 8 balls, and has given up 2 home runs.
And you talk about it, we talked about it, it takes away an advantage from a pitcher and gives the advantage to the hitter because they know if they happen to get hit, he may get thrown out of the ball game. So it takes away some of his aggressiveness. And one thing about Kerry, some guys can get away with pitching the ball up in the zone. And you hear us say so many times they cannot get the ball up in the zone, keep the ball down. Well, it's just the opposite with Kerry. He needs to keep the ball up a little bit higher. Man, that's wicked right there.
And down on strikes goes Blum, but back-to-back homers for the Astros extends their lead to 3-0. Bagwell and Ward go deep in the middle of the Cub order, tries to get them back in the game next.
Tonight, baseball strike talk swing and miss here in Chicago. Could players still take a walk? We'll have the latest tonight on WGN News after the game. This fall on WGN, Chicago's WB.
This portion of Chicago Cubs baseball on WGN is brought to you by Dodge. You can take life as it comes, or you can grab life by the horns. Dodge.
During the Dodge summer clearance, we can give you thousands of reasons to drive a new Dodge. Or we can give you zero. Because there's only one thing better than getting 0% financing for up to 60 months on select Dodge vehicles. It's getting 0% financing and our 7-year or 70,000-mile powertrain limited warranty. Something you don't get from Ford, Chevy, Honda, or Toyota. 0% financing and our 770 warranty. More than enough reason to get to the Dodge summer clearance.
In a valley, near a river, there's a place called Perfect. In Perfect, parents are informed of school projects 2 weeks ahead of time. There's always milk in the fridge, and the grass is green on both sides of the fence. Of course, we don't live anywhere near perfect, so we have Walgreens, open every day, many 24 hours, where we can get what's needed for the real world. That's life. This is Walgreens.
This portion of Chicago Cubs baseball on WGN is brought to you by Walgreens, the pharmacy of the Chicago Cubs.
Well, Sammy Sosa brought the whole family out to the ballpark here tonight, and why not? National League co-player of the week, a huge road trip, and he rips that one foul back toward the press box for strike one from Roy Oswalt. Outside, one ball, one strike, just a shade past the 8 o'clock hour here in Chicago. And the Cubs trail by 3. Off speed pitch. Boy, he's tough when he gets that over successfully. 1-2. No offense intended, but facing Roy Oswalt, a little bit different than facing some of the pitchers the Cubs saw in Colorado.
Well, you're absolutely right, because with Dane Nagle. A lot of off-speed stuff, changeups, but Oswald, he'll come right at you with a good live fastball, breaking ball, and that nasty change.
Driven in the air to right field, but not deep enough. Merced will make the catch. One man is down here in the fourth inning. Before Fred McGriff comes up, let's pause for station identification.
This is America's number one sports station, WGN-TV, Chicago's WB.
Chip and Joe from Wrigley Field, game one of a four-game series with Houston. McGriff hit by a pitch. He's one home run behind Stan Musial and Willie Stargell on the all-time list. Fred with 474 in his career. And he, too, had a very good road trip. He's knocked in 13 runs and has hit four out of the ballpark in his last 11 games.
Well, he's going to need some new lumber if he wants to do any more damage. Oswald saws him off. And the home runs as first basemen. So you see McGuire, he's first there, but creeping up in the background is the crime dog, the legendary Jimmy Fox. And Lou Gehrig.
And that statistic begs the question, where else has McGriff played defensively besides first place? Now remember, he's a DH in the American League. Well, let's see, has he played any other position?
No. Oh.
Wow, strike three, two outs.
On the corner, and Fred McGriff has a long look at him. Umpire Mark Carlson. He thought this ball was outside. You're talking about hitting your spots right here. Look how far McGriff is off the plate. And when you're that far off the plate, you're really susceptible to the outside pitch. And if you get a pitcher who can hit that spot, and that's going to be tough to cover.
And he also hit the glove, and he's been around the plate all night, which doesn't help the pitcher's cause. Here's former Astro Moise Salou. He walked his first time up. If you missed it, Moise said while we were on our Western trip that this offseason he's going to rededicate himself physically, really for the first time, but more so since any time since he's reached the age of 35 and beyond. He's going to really work on those legs, get them stronger for the 2003 season. And now with one very cold spring under his belt in Chicago, he feels he'll be much better prepared to turn in the kind of numbers everyone thought he would here in Chicago. Oswald continues to mosey right along. He's allowed only one hit through four and leads the game 3-0.
I'll be right out. Let me just put this Bud Light away.
Hey, Otto. Come on.
Honey, where's Otto? Otto? Otto?
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
Ford authorized clearance. 0% for 60 months is back. With cash back from $1,500 to $3,500. Or 0% APR on Focus, Taurus, Explorer, F-Series, Windstar, and more. That could save you over $6,300 in interest on a 2002 Windstar. 0% on Focus, Taurus, Explorer, F-Series, Windstar, ZX2, and more. So get to your local Ford store today.
SBC has state-of-the-art telecommunication networks located across the country. Our competitors have access to them. At SBC, we have multi-billion dollar plans to develop new technologies. Most of our competitors have marketing plans. We have switches, routers, towers, wires, trucks, repair crews, tool belts, and hard hats. They have salespeople. See, these days, not everyone selling phone service is what you'd call a phone company. Middlemen? Yes. Providers? Yes. But a phone company? Our lines, our networks. Infinite expertise. SBC.
That's about how big the baseball looks to the Cubs. They're seeing a crescent Cowhide tonight. Oswalt has allowed just one hit through four. And one defensive change for the Cubs. Angel Echeverria has taken over at first base. Remember, Fred McGriff was hit by a pitch leading off the second inning. Don't think he hurt himself looking at strike three, so that knee must have flared up on him, and hopefully Fred will be able to go tomorrow. Brad Ausmus with a single into center. That's five hits for Houston.
It was back in the second, late in the second inning off, when Fred McGriff came to play the very first pitch. Oswalt with that slider and hits him right on the shin. The right shin there, and I think Fred was able to continue after that.
Bunting situation for Oswalt. He's sacrificed three times on the year. Want to welcome a big friend of the Chicago Cubs, Doug McCoy, to the ballpark tonight. Doug threw out a ceremonial first pitch earlier this evening, and he's on hand tonight to see the Cubs hopefully beat young right-hander Roy Oswalt tonight.
Now, is his neighbor still the Hatfields?
Quite possibly. Bruised right shin for McGriff.
So that was right. Hit right shin.
Doug McCoy, again a friend of the Cubs, being escorted around Wrigley Field by the fine vice president of broadcasting and marketing of the Chicago Cubs, John McDonough. And as you see, Scott Rowland, for the second straight game, has started to heat up for St. Louis. They've tied things at three up in Pittsburgh. John's been very busy these days. As Oswalt bunts foul, John is personally responsible for hand painting every single one of the Kyle Farnsworth bobblehead dolls that will be given away during this homestand, as well as making sure that there are absolutely no typographical errors on any of the baseball cards that are going to be given away. On August 16th with Sammy Sosa. No balls, two strikes to Oswalt, and he bunts with two strikes and strikes out. Seven strikeouts for Wood. Oswalt cannot advance Ausmus, and now Vizcaino will hit for the first time. Remember, he took over for Julio Lugo when Kerry Wood hit him by a pitch in that third inning. One on, one out. Vizcaino, a former Cub, been a very valuable player for Jimmy Williams this year. Yeah. Play everywhere in the infield, even in the outfield if he has to. But another veteran presence on a very good Houston team.
And you look at the numbers, 304, one home run, 18 RBIs. You talk about improving your depth on the bench. This is something the Cubs could use, because they don't have that much depth on the bench. You look at Merced, Vizcaino. They've got guys who come in and are veteran ball players, left-handed players, who can go out there and do a phenomenal job in a pinch, and you need those guys on every championship ball club.
Well, Jim Hendry, the fine GM of the Cubs, knows he's got his work cut out for him. In this month of August, September, and in the offseason, there will be a lot of new faces on this Cub team, a lot of them from the farm system. As that one up the middle, Gonzalez can't get it. Vizcaino with a safe single into center. Ausmus stops at second, two men on with one man out. And again, a chance for Biggio, who struck out and hit into a double play. Wood not the same guy since hitting Lugo in this game.
And rightfully so, because you take away his aggressiveness, and now he's got to be more fine-tuned, kind of a pinpoint control. And as a power pitcher, you don't want to go out there and have to rely on finesse or your location or worry about, let me aim the ball here. You want to just rear back and throw it like he was doing very smooth and freely the first two innings. That's a totally different Kerry Wood.
That one skips up there, and Hundley, a good stop. Our producer of Cubs baseball on WGN tonight is Pete Tolma. Our game is always directed by the incomparable Skip Ellison. Mark Brady's our associate producer and the executive producer of WGN Sports, and that fine animated classic Slammin' Sammy is Bob Forwall. Check swing, did he go? No.
And all kids like cartoons.
It's a great cartoon. Yeah. I'm serious. Bob's the guy that's responsible.
Did you
just
Bob likes it. We like it.
Giving him his props, as Dr. Evil said so eloquently. Austin Powers too. Throw right past him. Two balls and a strike. Houston's done a great job in situations like this, hitting 323 in their last 40 games with runners in scoring position. When they get chances to score, they come through. Wood evens the count, two balls, two strikes.
Chip, getting hit by a pitcher as Craig Biggio did one game in Houston against with Kerry Wood, and a lot of times that can have a very lingering effect, because every time you face him, it's going to be in the back of your mind, and you see Craig Biggio doesn't look very comfortable in that batter's box facing Kerry Wood, because he's always got that in the back of his mind.
Little roller hit to the right side in between hop Echeverria. Good play. Wood beats Biggio to the bag. Dangerous play by the all-star second baseman of Houston. I hate that play.
Well, the thing is, the reason why you hate that right there, because sliding to first base, you can injure a hand, and in that particular situation, Kerry Wood could have stepped on his hand. Biggio here just trying to keep the ball, and Kerry was a little bit delayed getting off the mound, and that almost cost him. There's a hustling Biggio, and you take a look. Oh, that was oh so close.
And you can't tell me that diving like that is faster. You hit the ground, you slow down. If it were faster, Carl Lewis and all the great sprinters would dive on the track when they got to the finish line.
Yep. That's concrete. Well, asphalt.
So's this dirt. It's not exactly soft.
But you can slide on the dirt. It's like still in second base. You slide and you pop up.
I mean, Kenny Lofton, you remember, dislocated his shoulder a couple of years ago on a play like that. Countless men. Rondell White, you recall, when he was with the Cubs, hurt himself at second base on a head first slide.
But don't you love it, because it looks like they're hustling, doesn't it?
Well, that's the key. It looks like they're hustling. And I'm not just picking on Biggio. It's just a play that I wish somehow, some way, managers would tell their players not to do it. Just stay upright, go in, feet first.
Yeah, the way you get to first base, it's always quicker to run through the bag, straight through the bag. That's as quick as you're going to get there.
So Wood will go to the windup now and face Berkman, who struck out twice, once on a fastball, once on a slider.
Get too upset now, partner.
I'm not. I just want to.
Easy.
I don't want these guys to get hurt.
Boy.
I don't want them to get hurt. You're just trying to antagonize me today, aren't you? You're doing a very good job of it.
Who, me?
Who? You're flush with victory from your torment to the ball players last evening.
Well, they had a good time in Colorado and away with 2 out of 3. The Cubs did. Right now, they got bigger problems on their hands. Now, Kerry Wood is kind of finding that zone once again that he had in the first couple of innings. Good inside fastball down and in to Lance Berkman. Big at bat here. Two on, two out.
Well, you gotta admire Kerry Wood's pluck. He strikes out another man. That's 8 in the game, and through 5 innings, he's down by a 3-run score.
Hey, Joe.
Hey.
We can't take him to the coast with us. You mind?
The coast, huh?
This is where we're gonna be. There's his acupuncturist.
Hey, I've never taken care of a weasel before.
It's a ferret.
If you guys have to do duties, just let me know. Have a great time. See ya.
Why wait? You can fly Southwest Airlines from Chicago Midway to select cities in the Midwest for just $34 when you purchase by August 19th. So get packing.
Hey, you are now free to move about the country.
0% for 5 years ends September 3rd. Buick, recipient of two J.D. Power & Associates Initial Quality Awards, celebrates this recognition of superior initial quality with 0% for 5 years. That's nearly $4,000 in average finance savings. Or take $3,000 cash back on every new 2002 Buick. 5 years of interest-free financing ends September 3rd. See your Buick dealer today.
We should learn French.
Why would we want to learn French? French. Oui.
Introducing Mega Millions, the new big game from the Illinois Lottery. Jackpot start at 10 million. Play Mega Millions.
This copyright telecast is presented by the authority of the Chicago Cubs and may not be reproduced nor retransmitted in any form. And the accounts and descriptions of this game may not be disseminated without the express written consent of the Chicago Cubs.
Tonight's celebrity bat kids are Jeff Aronson, 11 years old, from Buffalo Grove, Illinois, and 10-year-old Samantha Charles from Antioch, Illinois. They're having a great night at Wrigley, thanks to Walgreens, the official pharmacy of the Chicago Cubs, and they got an official Sammy Sosa autograph baseball. What a deal! Way to go, Sammy. He's always very generous with his time with the youngsters. And here in the fifth inning we go with Corey Patterson leading things off. 3-0 in favor of Roy Oswalt. We have a young man in our booth who's going to turn things right around for us. Young Ryan McDonough, the son of John McDonough, the Cubs marketing department.
How you guys doing?
We're good, and you are a future broadcaster, we understand.
I'm trying. I'm, you know, watching you guys every day, and you guys
don't do that. That's the surest way. Not to. Well, go at it. Here you go. Corey Patterson's up. Come on, give us a couple hitters. Let's see what you got.
All right, here we go. Corey Patterson with a 2-1 count, and the pitch is fouled back.
Hey, I like him better.
I'm gonna go inside and have a couple of sodas and stuff to sit back and watch you go, Ryan.
You guys are the best. I'll leave this one to you, all right?
Oh, come on.
You're doing good.
There's a fly ball at right center. That's got a chance to go. And it's gone.
The kid shows up and Patterson hits a home run. How about that?
Yeah, but he's working for free. He may take our job, Chip. Corey Patterson gets the Cubs on the board. His third home run in 2 days. And all to the thanks of Ryan McDonough.
All right, looks like we got a chance to come back here. We're only down 2 now. There's still plenty of time to turn it around.
12 homers on the year for Patterson, his third in the last couple games. And he smoked that ball down and in. And off to the races was Patterson. And Southwest Airlines says, Joe, it flew
370 feet. That right there, that may be the thing that kickstart the Cubs, because Roy Oswalt was hitting the spots, and when Corey Patterson can get that fastball down the middle of the plate and extend on it and go through it like that, that's the Corey we saw the first part of the year, Chip.
And Alex Gonzalez is the hitter. So, Ryan, when you become a big-time famous broadcaster, are you going to embarrass your dad like we tried to do on the broadcast?
Oh, yeah, every time.
Ooh. Now, is it true? We heard a rumor, and we talked about it earlier tonight, that your dad is personally in charge of painting all the Kyle Farnsworth bobblehead dolls.
Exactly. He's been doing it for the last few months.
Yeah.
Occasionally he asks for help, and, you know, if I'm working or doing something else, I'll try to give him some help.
Swing and another drive. That one's crushed. It's a one-run game, Ryan. That's about as far as you can hit it here. Way out in left center field, past the camera well. 3-2 score with nobody out.
Boy, we saw the Astros go back-to-back with Bagwell and Darrell Ward. And now the Cubs turn the trick with Corey Patterson and Alex Gonzalez. And, Chip, this was a humongous blast. 12th home run this season for Alex, and there was no doubt about it. And Oswalt gets a fastball and runs up and in. And this ball is tagged. And Southwest said it flew 415 feet.
Now, you'll remember the last time Oswalt pitched here, it was smoking hot.
Yes.
Remember? He almost passed out on the mound. And Todd Huntley takes a strike here in the fifth inning. Still very hot, very muggy, and Oswalt's slight of build. Wonder if he might be getting a little weary here in this inning as the Cubs have hit about 800 feet worth of home runs against him with nobody out. And quickly, Ryan McDonough, Todd Huntley's down two strikes.
Well, you know, like I said, there's still plenty of time, and, you know, the two runs are going to help already. So it'd be nice if he gets a hit here, but if he doesn't, it's all right. Still turning around.
Where they're creeping up on the San Francisco Giants, and when you hit 13 home runs the last three games, you're going to move up the ladder. And right now, the Cubs are playing long ball here at Wrigley.
Fastball takes care of Todd Huntley. That's five strikeouts. Todd is 0 for 2. And his struggles continue with Kerry Wood coming up in a one-run game. So, Ryan, where do you want to head to school?
Well, as a matter of fact, it's funny that you mentioned that, because today I just checked
out. Don't say Georgia.
No, not Georgia.
He's way too smart to go to Georgia.
No, we checked out DePaul University today.
Oh, cool.
It's about 5 minutes away from here, so great campus. It's about 5 minutes away from here, so my dad had a quick drive on the way back, and you know, still got a lot of time to make a good decision. But
now your dad's a vice president, right?
Yeah, I can call him that.
Is DePaul a pretty expensive school?
It depends if I get a grant or not. So
it's way. I mean, you got to find the most expensive school that you can go to, because I know your dad has a printing press in the basement.
Exactly.
But Ryan, usually when you go away to college, you usually want to go away from where your parents are. You know, go out of town so you can have your own freedom.
As long as you're not coming home every weekend and you're staying on campus, you're still away.
Well, I know wherever you go, your folks are going to be awfully proud of you, Ryan, and your dad talks about you often, and we all wish you the best. And you've done a great job so far here tonight. It's your first Major League Baseball broadcast. I'm sure it's going to be the first of many, and you got the Cubs going tonight. Thanks for coming out to visit us.
Thank you guys very much.
You're the man.
Thanks. Good job, Ryan.
Tell your dad to do an extra good job painting those bobbleheads.
I will do that.
All right.
All right. Thank you.
All right. Ryan McDonough with us this afternoon at Wrigley Field. Two runs are in with two men out. Mark Bellhorn, the batter, and he's 1 for 2.
And Chip, he did the cardinal sin.
First major league spill, too.
Yeah, he knocked over the water.
Ground ball to the second baseman. Biggio makes the play, and that retires the side. Cubs get two back-to-back homers. Patterson and Gonzalez touch up Oswalt. And at the end of five innings, new life for the Cubs. It's a 3-2 Houston game.
Hi. How do you know that beer's fresh?
It's, it's on the bottle.
In the bottle? Can you show me, please? Because I
sure.
Looked.
Take a look right there. It's
Oh, those are the ingredients.
Oh, really?
Can you show me again?
Well, because it's sorry about that right there.
The UPC code?
Right.
That's just the name of the
then
bottle.
You come to the.
There we are. See it right there?
No, I don't.
It's all good.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Well, thanks for coming in.
Summer's going fast, and so is 0% at your local Chevy dealer.
Might as well be walking on the sun.
So hurry in for the last days of 0% APR for 60 months on select new 2002 Chevy trucks. Or choose $2,500 cash back on Trailblazer, Trailblazer EXT and Avalanche, or $3,000 on S10.
So don't delay, act now, supplies are running.
Get in by September 3rd and get 5 years interest-free at your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Chevy dealer.
Pizza Hut knows the best pizza.
It's one that's delivered on time.
So we're making big changes around here.
We've added more people to take your order.
And we've retrained our crews to serve you better.
We are moving in here.
Your pizza will be delivered when we say it will.
And if your pizza isn't delivered within 5 minutes of when we promise,
your next Pizza Hut pizza is free.
Free?
Free.
Guaranteed.
Why trust anyone else to deliver your pizza?
Call now and get a large one-topping stuffed crust pizza for only $9.99. Put Pizza Hut to the test.
The well-appointed Infiniti i35 with an award-winning 255 horsepower V6. Lease an i35 brilliantly equipped for $399 a month, because driving is the destination. Infinity, accelerating the future.
Kerry Wood's offense has brought him to within a run of the Astros after five. 3-2 our score, four home runs hit tonight. Patterson and Gonzalez have gone deep for the Cubs in back-to-back fashion. Bagwell and Ward have touched up Kerry Wood, and it's Bagwell here in the sixth. Out of play for a strike. Well, while Joe mops up, we'll run down the rest of the Major League scores. Young Ryan McDonough, just like his dad, can't control the Cubs.
All right, we're all set.
All right. 0-2 to Bagwell. He's backing away. One ball, two strikes.
One thing, when you can get the ball up in the air as a hitter, the ball will travel, and Gonzalez, wow. It's Bagwell. Goes down from that breaking ball.
That set up the outside corner, but Carey missed away. Two balls, two strikes. 8:30 here in Chicago. Cardinals have tied the Pirates 3-3 after four. Colorado leads in Florida 1-0. That one in the bottom of the eighth inning. Colorado, they had a disastrous last road trip. They went 2-10. After Florida, they go to Atlanta next. Full count to Bagwell. Very light National League schedule. Big matchup tomorrow. Arizona in Cincinnati. Giants visit Atlanta. Dodgers are in Montreal. Wild card hopes abounding. And that's over the outside corner. No argument from Bagwell at first. Then he thought it was too far outside. And to say to Mark Carlson, if you don't call ball three a strike, how can that be a strike? For it looked like the same pitch.